the next guy is a performer all the way from France. His name is Pepe. Jean-Claude Pepe. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your warm hands together for Jean-Claude Pepe.
Bonsoir. My name is actually pronounced Jean-Claude Pepe. Yes? Maybe some of you will have heard this name, yeah? Because basically I am the most popular and beloved actor in all of France. You know, if I will be in a movie in France, everyone in my home country will say, oh my God, I will have to buy a ticket for that, yes? And it will be lying around the block, you know? I have been in many, many, many films. I have been in drama film, like I was recently in a film called The Lonely Boy, which was recently named the saddest film in all time. The saddest. They will show it to gangsters, you know, tough guys who will kill their own mother, you know? And they will show it to them and they will cry. And they will show it to stupid people, you know? People who are so stupid, you know, like from a hospital, you know? People who you can tell them, your best friend just died, and they will say, what flavor is the pudding tonight, you know? And we will show them this film and they will cry. Because there is just something in my performance that will get to everyone, you know? And I will be also in comedy film. I was just in a very funny film called Where Are You Going With My Loaf of Bread? And the whole film is shot from the point of view of this loaf of bread, which is it's a very special loaf of bread, you know. It is baked for a contest, you know. And all of the thing which happened to it is crazy. It's a very funny film. I have won so many awards in France, I cannot count them, maybe a million awards. So I am here now tonight because today I have made my premiere in American film, which is very big for an actor from France, because maybe you will know about Gérard Depardieu, you know? You know, everybody in France knows that he is a terrible actor. He is only a nose, you know? If you will put some kind of normal nose upon his face, he would be nobody. He would only be gang raping women in Paris for the rest of his life in anonymity, which is a hobby of his. A lot of people don't know that, but he has done it. So every French actor want to come here and beat him here, yeah? So this is big. So a couple of nights ago, I am in my chateau in Rouen with my mistress, having a glass of wine. And the phone rings, and I think maybe it is my wife. Be quiet, you know. But it was my agent. And he says to me, you have been given an offer to appear in American film. Very exciting, you know. He says, you must be on a plane right away, pack a bag. This film is called, he tells me, The Doctor Who Will Do Nothing for His Patient. But there's no time to explain. And I think all the time on the plane, a doctor who will do nothing for his patients. The possibilities of this have no limit, you know? Who is this doctor? People come to him and beg him, save my life, please, and he will do nothing. Is it because he has realized the futility of life, you know? Is it because maybe he has realized, who am I to play God, you know? This is a very profound film, you know? Very exciting stuff, okay? So I think all the time, who is this doctor? And then I arrive and I get to the hotel and there is a note for me at the front desk and it says, Jean-Claude, welcome to Los Angeles from the production crew of Dr. Doolittle number 4. Okay. And then there is a phone number, but there is no script. So I call the number right away. You've got to send me some script, yes? And the woman, she laughed at me. She said, you don't need no script. And I say, my God, we're going to improvise this whole story. What a great idea. We will not be able to hide behind some writer's words. It will be the actors speaking from our souls about fear and death. Yes, I can do this, you know? And so I say to the woman, I think I can speak from the soul of this Dr. Doolittle about why he will not treat his patients. And then she laughed at me again and she said, you will not play Dr. Doolittle, you will be the maitre d'. I think, okay, who is this maitre d'? Maybe this doctor will go to his favorite restaurant every night and confide in the maitre d'. And the maitre d' is the only person who knows, and he must struggle. Will I go to the police? Yeah? So I'm up all night trying to think, who is this maitre d'? What's inspire him? You know, how does he dance? You've got to know how a character dances. That's a secret. So, in the morning I go to this set. And when I get to this set is when I learn a very many important thing about this film. Number one, this is not a film about a doctor who will not treat his patient because of a moral crisis. This is a film about a person who can hear animals speak. This is very stupid. For several reasons. First of all, if you could hear some animals speak, all you would hear is, I am hungry, I have to have sex. Please don't eat me, I will outrun you. And secondly, you cannot hear them think. There's no possible way. And why would they be able to speak English in full sentence, all of them? It makes this stupid film. And then I also learned that the maitre d', we're not going to improvise this movie. I don't need a script because the maitre d' only has one line in the film. The scene is that Dr. Doolittle is at a fancy French restaurant eating with a raccoon. And the raccoon is eating escargot. And he says, this is delicious, what is it? And Dr. Doolittle will say, these are snail. And the raccoon will make a gagging noise and I will come over and I will say, is everything all right? And then the raccoon will vomit in my face. For a really long time. Somebody say to me, 8 gallons of vomit. Now I try to point out to the director 2 problems. Number one, if Dr. Doolittle can listen to animals speak, why is it okay to eat these snails? Would they not also have human intelligence? Number two, a raccoon does not have a problem with eating snails. A raccoon is a natural predator of the snail. He will eat it, no problem. If you would tell a raccoon these are snails, he would say, yeah, very good, you know? In a world where he can say things. But nobody wants to hear my complaint about this scene. It's, let's get back to work, everybody. Okay, fine. So, apparently it's very difficult to make the raccoon vomit. Something is wrong with the device which is pumping the vomit through the puppet. It is only a puppet. The first take, some of it gets on me, but not, they really want a lot. So it is cut, and we try it again, but I said, well, I should change my suit because I have some vomit on here now, and it would not make sense in the second take to start with vomit, and the director says, buddy, it's close enough for straight to video. Then it is hours and hours and hours of trying to get the raccoon to vomit on the greatest actor in all France. After 4 hours, where everyone is yelling at each other and very angry and acting very unprofessional, that is when the director yelled, you know what? We don't need this scene anyway. Let's cut it. That's lunchtime. And just like that, I'm not in the movie. And so I went to where they were serving lunch, but my name was not on the list. And so I was not able to eat lunch. And I'll tell you something, it smelled very good to me. And so I wandered the streets of Hollywood with the palm trees and the Mexican people. And then I see this long line outside of a comedy theater and I say to myself, you know something, Jean-Claude, that's what it's really all about. Forget about making it big in American film. Forget about compete with Gerard Depardieu. Who cares about him? Performing for the people, yeah? Isn't that what it's really all about? Yeah. That's fine. Just a couple of applause, it's fine. So ladies and gentlemen, what I'm going to perform for you right now is a very, very funny, hilarious pantomime. About a man who is trying very hard to keep his hat upon his head, even though there is a terrible wind blowing on him. I think you'll find this very, very funny. And so now, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the greatest actor in all France, really, performing The Windy Day. My friends, I have been informed that there is no time for the pantomime by the host of this show. I will be returning to France tomorrow. I'll let you know if I ever come back. Good night!